This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your host, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, at any time I want to.
No, we're cooking with evil guys.
Get mad now.
What
the voice of the must be heard. Bigot, rape, and discrimination. The crime which are weakening America against you.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
Well, damn it, Casey, if you'd stop picking at it, it would heal up. Oh, hi. Didn't see you there. Welcome to another episode.
Oh, Jesus.
Welcome to another episode of Openly Hostile Opinions. I'm Jay, and my itchy motherfucker over here is Casey.
Yes, my hands are fucking, you can't see it.
Sure, it's your hands.
Yeah, my hands are peeling. They look like fucking I've jerked off like 70 times a day. It's driving me nuts.
And to be fair, you probably have.
Yeah.
You are single.
68 times. It wasn't quite 70. There's something on my screen and it's driving me nuts. we're off to a good start. We're very professional here.
All right. First thing to get out of the way, we've got a new member of the Board of Badasses, as we discussed last week. Oh, that's not the sound.
you're not toilet water to us.
Right here. Glorious.
Like we said last week, we want to add someone to the Board of Badasses. Her name is Cricket. You've been awesome. You've been posting feedback and stuff like that. And you said we're awesome. I can't really.
And you bought a shirt.
Yeah, and you bought a shirt.
People who buy shirts are cool.
Like we said, you've been, you know, watching us and stuff. You even tried to, you know, tell your friends about us and everything like that. So we want to thank you. We want to put you up here. Hopefully, I don't break anything like Jay did last time.
Good slap.
Yeah, good slap. Sorry, Cricket, if I slapped you too hard.
Hopefully our lights don't fuck with it because it's a little hard to read.
Yeah,
oh, well,
yeah, it whatever. Is. But you're back there and in our hearts.
And now we get this cool Matrix music in the background.
So. Yes, we do. I love that movie. Jay doesn't like those movies, but I love them.
The first one's okay, but the plot holes, man, the plot holes.
Yeah, I know, but it's just, I don't know. All you need to know about the Matrix is machines try to take over the world.
And there's no acting. None.
Well, it's Keanu Reeves.
But you know what? All the rest of them, even Lawrence Fishburne, who can act, was pretending not to act.
Yeah, I know. That reminds me, Ron actually watched John Wick. John Wick, he loved it.
Yeah, I still have to see the second one. Don't tell me shit. I didn't get there yet.
Oh, yeah, that's right. But anyways, thanks again, Cricket. You've been awesome. We really appreciate it. Thank you very much. God bless.
I guess next we should go to our...
Yes. The beer. This one I just bought because the fucking name was funny. It's called This One Time at Band Camp Double IPA. And I have a picture of it here for anyone watching on YouTube. That's the label. It's by Evil Genius. I've never had personally something from these people, but Jay... Jay has, and he says they make really good beer.
Yeah, I don't know this particular one, though, so let's give it a shot.
Yes. Cheers, mate.
Cheers. Ooh, that's got a kick to it.
Yeah, but that's actually a mild IPA, don't you think? Or is that just me?
I think we're just getting spoiled.
Yeah, because that's very mild to me as an IPA.
It's got that floral hoppiness to it as opposed to the grapefruity hoppiness.
Yeah.
Very well balanced. There's
that's
enough
the perfect
malt.
Word for it. Balanced.
Yeah, there's
it's
enough
really
malt
balanced.
To counteract the hoppiness.
Yeah.
I like it a lot.
Yeah, with a funny name, I didn't think it would be a good beer, but it actually is really good. You're right. Evil Genius, you can brew some beer. It is very fucking good. I like it.
A double IPA with an Evil Genius twist. We never use the same blend of hops twice. Each batch is unique and delicious.
Well,
maybe it'll suck for you when you go to try it. I don't know.
Yeah, I thought I was going to be sucking on a flute with pussy juice on it. But
that's what we ought to rate the beer in today. Yeah. Pussy flutes.
Actually, I love it. I'm gonna rate it 4 out of 5 pussy flutes.
4 out of 5 pussy flutes. I'll go with that.
When I pop the thing up here on the picture, instead of the noise that we use usually, I'm going to make a flute noise.
Well, now they won't be expecting it.
Yeah.
Or they'll be expecting it.
I know.
Whatever.
I'm sorry. Don't expect the rape. Oh, Jesus.
What the hell, man?
I don't know.
Why do we have podcasts?
I don't know. It's actually pretty funny, too, because I know a lot of people that listen to podcasts that hate when people do that. I do it all the time. I'm just like,
well, you know what? I like the rawness of our show.
I know. Me too. I don't give a fuck. That's why I do it.
I don't want
to. You won't like it.
I don't want to be polished in.
I know.
In
I don't either. Like, I was reading about people, like, editing every out. Fuck that. I don't care. I didn't go to Harvard. I don't talk right. Whatever. I live in bumfucked Egypt.
You mispronounce everything.
Yeah, I don't give a shit. Whatever. Fuck it. I see what happens to people that go to fucking school these days. You're a bunch of brainwashed freaks. Speaking of that, what did I want to bring up? Malcav, our friend up here, he's on the wall of badasses. He sent us a little picture the other day. I guess on YouTube, we've got enough. I think this is what it was. We got enough views and stuff that YouTube started putting us on, like, under categories and everything. Or maybe it was just his feed.
I don't know. Either way.
Yeah, but he sent us a picture, and we made it under knowledge.
Yeah, we're under the knowledge category if you look for us on YouTube. Yeah. I don't know how.
But he did make a good point, and he says he thinks it's because I keep saying, you gonna learn.
You really think Google can, like, pick that
up, though? I don't know. Like you said, me when you were talking, no one can really figure out YouTube's algorithms. They sort of know how it works, but they don't.
Well,
so who knows, man?
I think it's because Google is run by wizards.
Yeah, probably. Magic exists. I don't know. There's a lot of things I'd put us under, but knowledge is not one of them.
I mean, we occasionally teach you some shit, but it's not very often.
Yeah, we basically teach you that, you know, it's good to be an alcoholic and everyone in the world's fucking batshit crazy.
And we make a lot of dick and fart jokes.
That's basically it. That's all you need today. What's the show about? Dicks and fart jokes.
Yeah, dick and fart jokes, current events, and the occasional, like, conversation about the rapist up the street who still hasn't gone to prison.
I know.
What the hell is wrong? What is wrong with the planet?
I don't know, man.
Fucker admits to being a rapist. And a year later.
Here's the thing. Like, I don't know if I mentioned this on the show or not, but the other day, actually, this was a couple weeks ago. He saw me and he's like, hey, you know, I don't like really coming around anymore. You know, people aren't really nice to me. And I'm just,
we'll
like,
go with that.
Yeah, I'm like, you're a child molester. Like, I don't know. It just
go, take that thought. Go with it.
Like, he was dead serious too. And I'm just like, dude, I just would be like, you touch kids.
Why would...
Oh, man. And the funny thing was, is the girl that he touched came in. Where did I see her? I saw her the other day, and I was just uncomfortable. Just uncomfortable. Oh, man.
How do you think it feels for her?
I know, like, but I just felt like, you know, I felt bad for her because, like, I felt like...
Well, she was a kid.
She was one of those donuts that no one eats because someone's finger went through it. I know. Like, no one wants that donut anymore. Oh, man. I like donuts, man.
You're on your own on that one. I'm moving along.
Hey, this is my show. I'd say what I want.
That's all on your side of the table. I'm like, wow.
What? Oh, man. I thought it was good. I'll be here all night. You gotta admit that was funny. I'm sorry. I'm stoked. See, this is why this is why I'm gonna die alone. I think I laugh at myself.
I'd say you're going to hell, but you're already gonna be there for many, many hours.
Already there. We should make that a shirt. Don't even say anything. Just have a donut with a finger on it.
Nope. Not doing it.
Bear claw.
No, sir. Not doing it. Oh,
Jesus Christ. Speaking of food. Segue. I'm going to cover a story here. It's actually a local story. This happened at our local high school. And I just want to cover this because I want to make a point. How everyone around here is not a bunch of sensitive fucking pussies. Our high school, someone was eating... And actually, this story also shows how redneck and backwoods my area is. I didn't know this, and I wish they served these when I was in high school, but they serve chicken bowls. Like, you know,
really?
Those, yeah. You know those things from KFC with like the chicken mashed potatoes and
everything? Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Yeah. They were serving that. Well, actually, I get a picture of it here. I'll show it real quick. Some kid found a worm in his potatoes and corn. And the funny thing is, and why I like this story, no one gives a fuck. They covered it. They said, we're not going to do anything about it. We like our lunch ladies. We really love them and everything like that. And the guy that even submitted this story doesn't want to be identified. Like, that's the end of it. Like, no one's freaking out.
Of course, it still made the news, so there's that.
Yeah, but look how short it is. It's like this long, and that's it. And the one guy says, I know the lunch ladies very well, and they're all really nice people. I know that we'll never intentionally do anything like that. They're really nice people here. To be honest, the lunch ladies are really nice. I know them, and they wouldn't do that stuff. The student who found the corn earworm in his lunch asked not to be identified. End of story. Like, that's news.
Well, it's a common, it's like a species of moth, and they end mm-hmm. up in corn ears.
Yeah. And I just like it because that's how our area is. If anyone watches us from our area, no one gives a shit. Everyone just is carefree. They're going to go home and drink Bush and beat their wife later that night. But, you know, that's none of our business. I don't know. I wanted to cover that because I, like I said, the way everyone gets so bent out of shape with everything these days, I just, it's nice to see someone just cover something.
You know, and it's nice to hear something about an earworm that's not not the type that gets stuck in your head and you can never forget about.
Yes. Did you update your speakers? That sounds really good. Oh, I love this song. The guy's gay as hell. That's what Family Guy said.
He's not.
He's not. Isn't this song about him loving a gay guy? What about that bartender? Actually, in this song, I gotta give it to the bartender in this video. He rips it up. You know what I'm talking about? The bartender in it?
Yeah.
Yeah. He just starts dancing and everything, and it's amazing. You're welcome, America. I love that song. Yeah,
I do too. I ain't even mad when I get Rickrolled.
Yeah, I wonder why Family Guy did that. Family Guy, when Brian went back to the future,
because they Rickrolled the because
he goes, this next song is from a gay guy.
He's not gay though.
Oh really?
He's been married.
I thought that whole song was about anal gay sex.
No.
Oh.
Anyway, yeah. That's one I don't mind, but yeah, they just did it to Rickroll the American public.
Oh, nice. Actually, someone did that. I think it was the Macy's Day Parade when that was getting big. Someone Rickrolled the whole parade.
Nice.
Yeah, that's awesome. I love it.
We're heading way back to the funny of 1998.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus Christ. Had a baby, it's a boy. Oh, man.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, that fucker's back. He's doing shit for Sprint.
I think it's brilliant.
I know, but I just think of the stormtrooper of Star Wars. Traitor! We should get that as a sound clip.
You go right ahead. You get your own soundboard. I'm not going to... That movie hurt me, and I don't want to think about it anymore.
Oh, Rogue One was great,
I'm like a battered woman shelter. Like, no, I don't want to... That movie hurt me. I don't want to think about it.
I know, that's the thing. Seven was all right, episode seven. Rogue One was fucking awesome.
I didn't see it. I have no desire to see it.
You're not going
to
see it. All right, well, I'm going to spoil things then.
Spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert. Okay, for anyone that hasn't seen it yet, but the reason why I like Rogue One is because everyone dies.
Such a downer.
I know, it's awesome. No one lives. Everyone dies. I love it. It is so awesome of a movie. Like, you remember the first Star or the third Star or which one is it? I think it's the New Hope, where they're like, we got these plans. A lot of people died trying to get them. These are the people that tried to get them, and they all fucking
Mini Bothans.
Yeah. I loved it. They all fucking, no happy ending, nothing. Well, it was sort of happy ending. But and at the end, there was this badass scene with Darth Vader, and they finally give him a scene to show how badass he is. Like, he walks through this like little hallway with like 50 guys in it, and he just fucking kills them all. It is so awesome. Good job, Disney. Actually, you know what I was? You know why I think this one was good? Because J.J. Abrams wasn't there to fuck it up. Fucking piece of shit. I hate J.J. Abrams. Go die!
You know, that reminds me of a comic, and I'm going to send it to your email real quick, so get into that.
Okay. I'm already in it, baby.
This comic makes me laugh my ass off every time I see it, and I figure we'll give it a quick shout-out for those of us on YouTube, and I'll describe it for those of you on the podcast.
I'll describe it.
Who far outnumber our YouTube viewers because, you know, nobody wants to look at us.
I don't blame you. I got like a fucking neck beard going on today. I got a shave.
What, it take you 6 months? Yeah. I think it'd be okay for a little while longer.
No, it's getting a little...
I can will mine to grow it.
Okay, here it is.
Yeah, pull that up and then show it on the screen there.
It's not a picture of a donut.
Not that
it?
One.
Oh my God. I was like, that doesn't look about Star Wars at
that's
all.
That's the other story. Hit the refresh button.
Refresh, yeah. Actually, this beer is getting pretty hoppy now.
Yeah.
The first taste was very smooth. Now it's like changing a little bit. All right, let's see what this malarkey is here.
All right, well, this is a comic from Blue Milk Special. It's a nonprofit web comic. It's not endorsed by Lucasfilms at all.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, so it's got Admiral Akbar on it. You got it on the screen? Good. He goes, you know how they say many Bothans died to bring us this information? It's got Admiral Akbar going, that's the last time I sent Bothans to do anything. I sent Bothans to get me a coffee all day.
It's actually pretty funny not to see him, you know, in something that says, it's a trap.
I just love that. I sent Bothans to get me a coffee all day.
It is pretty funny. Yeah. Yeah, I love the movie. If anyone wants to see it, it's fucking awesome. I suggest it. It's completely different from Episode 7. It's completely different. I fucking loved it.
Yo, can we just talk about that cough of yours for a minute now?
The what?
The cough. That is like the juiciest, nastiest cough.
What, my cough? Yeah, I smoke cigarettes.
I know.
Hey, what you want?
You think maybe you ought to stop that? Just a thought?
No. I love smoking. And I smoke, so I don't.
If I could quit, you could quit.
No, you don't understand. I have a very addictive personality, you know.
Oh, but I do.
Yeah, but you quit smoking, I didn't. So, who's the addict here?
No, I found something new to tinker with when I switched to e-cigarettes.
What's that? Pussy?
E-cigarettes. I tinkered with them.
I know, but now you don't use them at all.
Yeah, just because it broke one day. I'm like, fuck it! My laziness outdoes my need to tinker sometimes.
I actually gotta get an e-cigarette. I just keep putting it off because, like, I don't know. I
made you one, for fuck's sake.
I know, and I don't know what the fuck happened to it.
They got ones that are far beyond anything I used to make, though.
Oh, I know. The ones I see today are
people
are,
like, riding them to school and
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, I know. There's, like, pull start ones and shit, and I'm like, what the fuck? And I don't know. I see all these fucking videos of them exploding in people's pockets, and everyone's like dying from it, from popcorn lung or whatever the fuck that bullshit is.
Well, that's all the media sensationalizing stuff. Shocker.
Mm.
Well, any lithium battery, if you overstress it, which some people do by being stupid, can vent, and they vent violently.
Yeah.
Same thing what happens when cell phones explode. It's the lithium battery venting violently.
I know, and that's the thing. Like, when I see all these videos of all these e-cigarettes exploding in people's pockets, I'm like, Samsung's making e-cigarettes now.
Well, some of those batteries are probably made by Samsung, but they're overstressing the battery by using it in a manner it was not intended to be used. Because basically, an e-cigarette atomizer is a short.
Yeah.
You're running a short. And if you don't have a battery that can handle that with thermal protection, hey. You've got to run something that has some sort of over current or thermal protection, because if you don't, then, like I said, you're basically running a short.
Yeah.
You'll overstress the battery and blow it the fuck up.
I know. Thermal protection. That sounds like something you put over a vagina so you don't bleed. I'm just full of them today. The feminists are going to be going after me today.
Dude, we're going to end up like being heroes for a bunch of like fucking basement dwelling fedora wearing my lady fucking They don't even wear
the future.
Here's where I get to sound like a real hipster. They don't even wear fucking fedoras. They wear trilbies, goddammit.
I don't know what that is. Trilby sounds like a vaginal discharge. I don't know.
Okay, the hat that Indiana Jones wears is a fedora. The hat gangster wears is a fedora.
Okay.
The ones that these people wear are trilbies. They have those little folded up things in the back and the little... They're striped and they have a little feather.
I never understood fashion. I just don't get it. I don't know. Like, for women, yeah. But men, who gives a fuck, dude? Like, who cares? You all look like jackasses anyways. Men are ugly. Like, who gives a fuck, dude?
We are weird looking.
I know, dude. And
like look at the dick, for example. It's not even the same color as the rest of you.
Like, you get naked and you just have this fucking elephant trunk sitting there. And just, like, women are just like...
It's almost like when God was building us, he's like, I got these extra parts.
I know. Like, here you go. Just fuck it. Put it here. I got to take the black Play-Doh that's mixed with the white Play-Doh and make something out of it. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, they're not the same color. They got a seam running down.
Yeah, I know, exactly. It
looks like we're even put together.
I know. I just,
they're all wrinkly and hairy, and there's nothing good.
Jesus.
Nothing attractive about men's genitals.
I'm just thinking about women's bodies. I love them. I had this girl send me nudes the other day, and she has a great body.
She got that body karate.
She got that body karate. I wish.
That's a hammerism. Thank you, Hammer, wherever you are.
I wish I could post that, her nudes, because her body is just... Mm. Like, I just want to post them on the screen right now. I wish I could.
No.
It's just...
Bad.
But all the feminists would get pissed. They're like, she needs a hamburger.
If there was any feminists who watched this show, you would have scared them off by now.
I always wondered that. I'm like, I wonder if there's some fucking, you know, waffle-eating, syrup-drinking piece of fat cunt sitting in her basement and fucking watching this going,
Where did you ever associate waffles with feminism? This is not the first time you said this.
Because there's this movie, and I can't remember what it's called, but in the future... gaming, video games, becomes real, where you sit there and you actually control real people, and it's like...
Oh, you mean what rich people do to us?
Yeah, exactly. And there's there's two popular games. The most popular game in this futuristic setting, or whatever you call it, is a first-person shooter, and Gerard Butler is the main character,
and this
like 16-year-old kid controls him. And it's televised, and it's really famous and everything. Well, the next popular game is sort of like The Sims.
Yeah.
But you control other people and stuff like that. And this one guy that's controlling this girl because she needs to do this for money, so she lets people control her.
Oh, yeah.
He is this guy that's controlling her. It shows him, and he's in his basement. He's in, like, this wheelchair, and he's, like, 300 pounds. And he's dipping. He's folding whole waffles in half. And dip, like, they're like this big. Like the size of my head. And then he's folding them in half, dipping them in maple syrup and eating them. And it's just, every time I think of fat people, I think of that now. I don't know why. But it was a really, really weird scene.
You know, that reminds me of a game that I thought was badass back in the early 90s. It was called Night Trap.
Never heard of it.
It was on really? You never heard of that?
I've never heard of it.
All right, well, here's what it is. It was on Sega, the disc system. Sega's disc system that added
Sega Saturn.
No, not the Saturn.
Oh, I thought Saturn was the dicks.
Disc.
Dicks.
Dick system. No, it was the CD drive for the Sega Genesis. It was a Genesis game.
Okay. Ooh, just hit my mic.
And,
Sega! Do you remember that?
Yeah, I was a Sega guy. Nah, like I play more like SNES games now because I didn't have one growing up.
Yeah.
I had the Sega,
mm-hmm.
which I thought I was one of the cool kids because I go back to the advertisements. Sega does what Nintendo don't.
Was that the line?
Oh yeah, that was their thing.
I don't remember that.
So anyway, the cool kids had Sega, you know, and I was all about Sonic and shit back in the day.
Sonic was fun.
That was my
game got hard too.
Yeah,
that's no joke.
That was my shit. So anyway, and Comic Zone. Comic Zone's a great game. I never played that. It was great. I
never heard of that either.
But anyway, so there's this game called Night Trap, and basically what it was is you were this operative, and you were watching security cameras, and you were supposed to activate traps to get these vampire-like creatures called augurs. this group of people, these girls are having a slumber party.
Oh, this is getting good.
Yeah. Well, this is why back in the early 90s, you know, when you've got like fucking, you got like fucking Tipper Gore and all those people like freaking the hell out with the, you know, the RIAA and shit like that. Anyway, back to the story. You're this person watching these security cameras and you have to activate these traps to get the augers. And if you don't, they kill the co-eds. And, like, there's a famous scene. I sent it to you. You can bring it up. We can play it. Called the infamous bathroom scene. You can see how tame this was and how bad the acting was. But this game was notorious.
Oh, it's one of those games where it puts live action video.
Yeah,
in.
It was live action video. It was like a horror movie you could play. Here, bring it up.
Oh, that's hilarious.
And this game was badass back in the day.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Look at this terrible, terrible gameplay.
It's gonna work. You're not scaring me.
Those are the augers.
What are you doing?
Is that what is he holding? A hook?
They put it around their neck and drain your blood. This is the infamous scene that the reason why this game was so controversial.
I'd do her.
Look at this.
Oh my god, this is so good. I didn't know.
It's so cheesy.
I know, but I didn't. This was on the Sega?
Yeah, it was on the Sega disc system.
Jesus Christ.
I don't believe what I just saw. Those bloodsuckers just got Lisa, and you had a chance to save her.
See, look at this.
I put the lives of those girls in your hands, and you screwed up.
Oh man, you get bitched
I'm
at.
I'm plugging you before you do any more damage.
So when you get Jesus, you even get bitched at. Is this Marriage Simulator?
and here's the thing, Dana Plato was actually in that.
I have no clue who the fuck that
she,
is.
She was an actress from Different Strokes.
Oh.
Like she was a big name actress. She was actually in this.
Was that the girl that was getting her blood sucked?
No. She plays an undercover agent, and here's the best part. The agency was called SCAT.
I forget. See, that would have been funny. Like I would have, if I was SCAT, I would have had the training video. I'd be like, I'm the SCAT man.
It was a Sega Control Attack Team is what it stood for.
Oh my god!
Did nobody in that office go? Maybe not the best idea.
Who cares? You know why? Because that was back in the day where not everyone was offended about everything.
Yeah, the game was released on the Sega CD, and they later ported it to Sega 32X, and they even ported it to like Mac and MS DOS, and then they changed the name from Sega to Special Control Attack Team.
They're not special; they're just like everyone else.
Anyway, this game was fucking huge in the early 90s. They had congressional hearings over this. Because of like this and Mortal Kombat and Doom and another game called Lethal Enforcement.
Great fucking video games. I loved them.
In fact, Night Trap is largely responsible for the ESRB game rating system we have now. It was so controversial back in the day.
How is that controversial? How is that any different? That wasn't even bad. They showed no blood. They show what? A girl showed a little bit of cleavage? Oh, no. I can go to my local supermarket and see fucking cleavage. Who gives
but
a fuck?
But this is back in 92.
Who gives and a it... shit?
See, the hearings were chaired by Senators Joe Lieberman and Herbert Cole from Wisconsin. Anyway, they describe it as shameful, ultra-violent, sick, and disgusting.
Yeah, so?
Encouraging it. Here's where they got it all wrong. Encouraging an effort to trap and kill women. Because they were too fucking stupid to realize the entire point
women
of the game.
Women trap men all the time. It's called marriage. Get over it.
Because Jesus. They were too stupid to realize the entire point of the game was to prevent them
I
from
know.
Getting killed.
Like, oh my god. And that's the thing. This reminds me of the shit with Dee Snider from Twisted Sister, where someone killed themselves or some shit. Or no.
They were just talking about censoring harmful and sadistic
lyrics
music.
About how fucking Twisted Sister's lyrics were, you know, saying about Satan and rape and all this stuff. And Dee Snider goes to Congress and he's like, my music has nothing to do with that. And he's like,
educated. He's well spoken.
Yeah, and he rips into Congress like hardcore.
They were not expecting
A metal singer. You know, if you see him in the Twisted, we're not going to take it video. He looks like a drag queen. They're not expecting this guy to rip him a new a-hole. Well, he goes into Congress, rips him a new fucking asshole, and goes, "My music is nothing about Satan raping women and stuff like that." But he goes, "What bothers me is that you people have a seat in running this country, and you took that from my music. So what kind of imagination and mind do you have that that's where you go with my music?"
Right. Particularly, they're talking about a song called Under the Blade.
Yeah.
And that song was about getting surgery done because he was terrified of it. Like, he even says in here, "A glint of steel, a flash of light, you know you're not going home tonight, be it Jack or Switch, doctors or mine." Like, it explains that it's
yeah,
surgery.
And I just love that where he says, he goes, "I don't know what kind of mind you people have, but it scares me that you're actually run this country or help run it, and that your imagination went there." And he was like, "What kind of people are you?" Like, and it was a nice way of him saying, "You guys are sick fucks." And I don't know, you know, what, you know, donuts with finger holes in them that you masturbate to. But, you know, it was fucking awesome. That was a step for the metal army. Oh, Jesus Christ, man. It's really good. We're gonna have to share this video if anyone is interested in it, because it's really good. I think it was a documentary, wasn't it?
Well, yeah, but I'm not going to, like, show the video because I know this one is going to get us freaking...
Yeah, yeah. But it's a really good video. We'll post this on Twitter. Like we said, we're going to try to be better with doing stuff like that. But it is...
But we failed completely last week.
Yeah, I know. We got to get on it and everything like that. But, yeah. It's just a really good fucking video. And it just shows that they just judged him. They just judged him. They judged him too quick. They brought him into Congress, and they thought, you know, this was going to be some dumb jackass, but he fucking ripped Congress a new asshole, and I fucking loved it. Oh, man, it was great. And see, like, yeah. And that's what he says right there. He goes, "They thought they would bring me in, and I'd look like a jackass." But, you know, whatever. Skin tight jeans, my snakeskin boots, and a little bit of eye makeup left underneath, and my big hair. And I ain't getting dressed up for nobody. I'm a dirtbag, and I'm proud. And I'm playing these people like, you know, I mean, I've mentally, I'm setting these guys up for the kill. I have got my speech in my back pocket, which I have worked on for a few weeks and honed and refined till it's a freaking nuclear weapon. Folded up. Like a gazillion times, like a bad kid bringing his homework to school, you know, when I open it up and I'm flattening it out on the table, really delivered, and they're going, "Oh man, this is a lamb being brought to the slaughter." And I start reading. "Since I seem to be the only person addressing this committee today who has been a direct target of accusations from the presumably responsible PMRC, I would like to use this occasion to speak on a more personal note and show just how unfair the whole concept of lyrical interpretation and judgment can be, and how many times this can amount to little more than character assassination." And he's well spoken. Uh-oh.
"Everything that they've accused me of, disproving without a shadow of a doubt that everything they've accused me of has been wrong, false, and they are scrambling. They were saying that Under the Blade was about sadomasochism and bondage. It was about my guitar player's throat operation.
It's not really a wild leap of the imagination to jump to the conclusion that that's about something other than surgery or hospitals, neither of which are mentioned in the song."
"No, it's not a wild jump, and I think what I said in one part was that songs allow a person to put their own imagination, experiences, and dreams into the lyrics. People can interpret it many ways. Ms. Gore was looking for sadomasochism and bondage, and she found it. Someone looking for surgical references would have found it as well."
"Yeah."
"I said, you know, I can't help that Tipper Gore's got a dirty mind, and Al Gore just, oh my God, you know, he really jumped over the table. They were saying, we're not going to take it. We should be on the Filthy 15 for violence. And it was no more violent than the Declaration of Independence.
The PMRC rated songs according to violence, the occult, sex, drugs, and alcohol. And although
D. Snyder... All right, we're going to get off of this because we're getting into like some copyright material here.
But what D. said is absolutely right. You don't find anything other than what you want to find. I mean, if you wanted to believe that that video game was about entrapping and killing little girls, that's what you would have seen.
Yeah, like he said, he goes, typical, you have a sick mind. And he does. Like, if that's what you want to look for, that's what you're going to look for.
Right. I mean, they describe doctors and shit in the lyrics.
Yeah. Like, if you... man. That's Congress, though, for you.
Well, it wasn't even Congress. It was Tipper Gore. It was.
I know, but it was a Congress hearing, though, I think, wasn't it?
Well, yeah, Senate, it was brought in front of Congress.
Yeah.
But, you know, whatever. The whole thing's stupid. Censorship in general is stupid.
I know.
That's why I'm glad that we're able to do this on a platform where we're able to speak our minds for the most part.
Yeah. That's the thing. Like, when you live in a country where, the first fucking law, the first law is free speech, I think, move to another country, you don't fucking like it. Fuck you!
I mean, we're able to say, for the most part, what we want to. We can't do any sort of hate speech, but we're not hateful people.
Yeah, we're not. Well, I am, but whatever.
You're not.
Yeah, I am.
You're not. You're judgmental and an asshole, but
you're not. I fucking hate everyone. Everyone's a bunch of fucking oversensitive fucking pieces of shit. I can't take it anymore.
I fixed my fucking mic stand, but now the microphone cable is acting up.
Well, that's Jesus what happens Christ. When you throw your fucking microphone on the ground.
Well, you know, it was entertaining, wasn't it?
Yeah, but it doesn't entertain our wallet.
We spent $15 for these microphones. We're fine.
Yeah, I guess if that's what you want to call it. Yeah, but back to that. It's like we said, we're going to try to share that again.
Actually, hopefully. Yeah, I already closed the fucking window. Hang on. Yeah, I'll shut up.
it's just a great way to show that if you were prepared enough, you could do anything, and that's what D. Schneider did. He went in there. He was very well spoken and just ripped into these people because that's what I agree with the most. The best thing I like about that is, how he said about the interpretation. Everyone interprets things in a different way. They relate to different things, and it makes them feel a certain way. That's the whole point of music. That's the whole point of art. Art and music, they mean things to people because it makes you feel a certain way. So, this music that he was writing about that song was about his guitarist's throat surgery. When these other people read it, it was about Satanmasochist and all that bullshit. So what kind of minds do they have? It's just great. Fucking get him, D. Schneider.
And what really, really fucking screwed the PMRC hearings is because they invited John Denver, and they're thinking John Denver, Rocky Mountain High, he'll be on our side. He just fucking sided completely with Frank Zappa and D. Snyder and all these people.
Oh, I never knew about that. Oh, actually, yeah.
You should really watch the documentary.
I forgot about that. Actually, I do remember that now, yeah. Because I remember they were trying to get John Denver on their side, and he was like, no.
he said censorship is bullshit.
It is.
And, for the most part, it ended up being a fairly innocuous thing, just having ratings on CDs, but... Oh, excuse me. But they had ratings on CDs, but unfortunately, major retailers like Walmart and shit refused to carry CDs unless they were censored. So, mm-hmm. When I was growing up, I was within walking distance of Walmart, so I could go and I could buy CDs and shit there. But I wasn't within walking distance of any place that had the uncensored CDs, so I had to go and listen to shit where, they were fucking edited for content. And
yeah, I remember a lot of them weren't edited. They just put beep noises in.
Well, Walmart still would. But, it's just because
I know some, they would, change the lyrics and shit like that. But I know some, Metallica's Garage Incorporated came out. And, fuck you. Oh, no. What was that song? Shit. The one that he swears, talks about schoolgirls.
So what?
So what? Yeah, I remember they didn't even try with that. They just put beeps and everything.
Yep.
Yeah, Metallica's So What? They covered it. But every... It's a fucking awesome song.
And then there's Attack of the Killer Bees from Anthrax. It was like a best of compilation of their B-sides and shit. Every time there was a swear word, they just put bee noises in.
Oh my god.
Speaking of great CDs with very, very bad lyrics, the new Body Count album came out. And it was, it's called Bloodlust. It just came out March 31st. It's great if you want to check it out, if you're into that kind of music.
Body Count's awesome. I love them.
Yeah, they're it's really amazing. Good. They've got they've got fucking guest appearances by Dave Mustaine, Max Cavalera, Randy Blythe's on there.
Oh, really?
Is yeah, it? Yeah. And they even cover Raining Blood.
Oh, shit. Yeah, it's a mashup, too. Don't they mix Raining Blood with something
else? Yeah, with Postmortem.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's a great. I love Body Count. It's awesome. I'm glad Ice-T's fucking, you know, doing it up again.
I mean, he can't sing, but, you know, fuck it. He brings it.
He makes it work, though. You know, whatever. He doesn't really. He has more of like a. I don't know. Body Count to me is a, like, sort of old, stylish, late 80s, early 90s hardcore sound to it.
Well, the thrash.
Yeah.
And they have a little bit of crossover in there, too. But for the most part, they're just a thrash band.
Yeah, but I just like it that he, you know, he really doesn't sing. He just more like yells, you know what I mean?
Yeah, well, I mean, you can get away for a long time in a thrash band not being able to sing. Look at fucking Suicidal Tendencies. Well, they're crossover, but Suicidal Tendencies, man. Mike Muir cannot sing for shit, but I love Suicidal.
Yeah, and that's what I like about it, like older shit like that. A lot of punk music, like what's his name? He didn't even play bass half the time.
Which one?
Sid or whatever the fuck his name
Sid
was.
Sid Vicious.
Yeah, yeah, he didn't have his bass plugged in. He used to just wear it and jump around and hit people and shit. Like, that's what I liked about, like, older music and stuff. They didn't give a fuck. Now it's all polished. It's a big polished, you know, whole finger hole in a donut. Well,
to be perfectly honest with you, the Sex Pistols were completely manufactured.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
But it was intentional, completely intentional.
Yeah, I know, but it's just like...
A record producer who had dollar signs in his eyes found a couple of kids and...
I know, but that's to say, the band wasn't doing it. That was, you know, fucking what's his name or whatever the fucking piece of shit.
I don't remember the guy's name who put them together, but they were basically a boy band of their era, believe it or not.
Oh, yeah. No, I completely agree. It they made a movie called Send a Nancy for fans and shit like that. It's just, I don't know. It's just, back then, band members didn't give a fuck. Now everything is so organized and so polished. It's just...
And for the record, Sid wasn't a singer anyway. He was the bass player.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Oh, I thought you were saying he couldn't sing either.
No, I was saying it, but just about how people just didn't care.
Johnny Rotten was the singer.
Yeah. Like I said, he put the bass guitar on. He didn't even have it plugged in half the time. He just act like he was playing and jump around and shit. Like,
yeah, he couldn't play for shit.
Yeah, people didn't give a fuck.
He was a fan.
Yeah. And I might get slayed for this, but actually Kurt Cobain couldn't really fucking play guitar that well.
I don't think you'd get slayed for that. Nobody would. He was a great songwriter, but he was not a great musician.
Like, even if you watch MTV's Unplugged, he's horrible. Like, you watch him play, he's just like, eh.
Well, like they said... Oh, you're grunge. Like, really? I thought we were punk rock.
Yeah.
That's what
I heard
they
he
were.
Play a mean shotgun, though. But anyways. I don't play this game called Fallout.
Kerbang.
Fallout's a pretty popular game. A lot of people play it. I don't really like that style of game. But there's a shotgun in there, and it's called Kurt Cobain's Microphone.
You don't like RPGs?
Not that kind.
Do you like the MMO RPGs, but not a regular RPG?
No, like, it's not, I don't know, like, it's too slow. I don't know.
I'm a fan of RPGs.
Yeah, I am too, but it's just, it's a different kind of RPG to me. I just don't like it. It's too, I don't know. I like RPGs that are very multiple player and stuff like that. I don't know.
I actually like the slow progression in the story development of an RPG.
I do too. I don't like it. It's just too... I think it's because a lot of it came out in console, I think. Don't quote me on that. But I don't really like console games, RPGs. I think RPGs are meant to be played on computers. And I don't know. I saw my friends play, and they loved it. Like, when I lived with my friends Shane and Sam, they actually, you know, played it a lot. They were actually really excited when it came out. But I never got into it. Never did.
My favorite game of all time is called Earthbound. It's a Super Nintendo
Earthbound.
Yeah, it's a Super Nintendo.
I think we've talked about this before. Not on the show, I mean, like, personally.
Yeah.
But.
It's a Super Nintendo RPG, and it's set in, like, the 90s. And they've got this, but it's, like, the Japanese thought of what the 90s are.
Yeah.
And it's quirky. It's great. You've got, like, this alien thing. Yeah, and they're possessing animals. And you fight enemies like the possessed hippie. And, it's one of my favorite
things. We gotta censor this. It's teaching you to possess hippies.
It was based off a Japanese series called Mother. Mother One was originally...
Tell your children.
It was originally released on the NES, and it was just super grindy JRPG style.
And
it never ended up getting... It got totally localized and translated, but they never ended up releasing it because it. By the time they finished with it, it wouldn't have been able to make much of an impact. The Super Nintendo had already been released. So they ended up translating the second installment in the Mother series, Mother 2, and then they released that as Earthbound. There was a third one released for the Nintendo Game Boy Advance called Mother 3 that never made it to the U.S., but there's a great fan translation of it out there you can use and patch a ROM and play.
Yeah,
I love them. They're like my favorite series of games ever.
I'll have to try them out.
They're really quirky. Yeah. Like, they're not very grindy. Well, the first one's grindy as fuck. Yeah.
No, see, I play World of Warcraft, so that doesn't bother me.
Well, the Nintendo, the NES one's grindy as fuck, but Earthbound, the second installment, like I said, is a lot easier to get into, and it's just fun to watch the story progress.
Yeah, see, I like that stuff. Like, I never got into Fallout. If I did, maybe I'd like it, but actually, I like the storyline and everything. Like, I think there's a nuclear fallout, and big surprise, nuclear fallout, and have a game called Fallout.
Our buddy Joe, who we really got to get watching this show somehow.
I wish we could have him on the show.
I would, too. If he ever comes back, he needs to come in. He'll come on.
Baby, come back.
He's in the Navy, so he...
Joe's all responsible and shit.
Who would have thought it? Anyway, he's obsessed with the Fallout series.
Oh, he is?
He used to be. I don't know if he still is.
I miss Joe. Joe, if you're watching this, I love you. Come back to me. We had such good times together. You vacuuming vomit.
Smacking a vacuum cleaner into the kid's face.
Yeah, into a blind guy. Like, just come back, baby. I miss, carrying you up the stairs when you're passed out on Vladimir vodka and hitting your head off the steps.
For the record, I turned him on to Vladimir because it was $2 cheaper than Banker's Club.
Something cheaper than Banker's Club.
I remember...
Never in a world.
I remember having to hold him down to stop him from attempting to shave after he had drank an entire fifth of Vladimir.
I shaved one time when I was drunk. And I wasn't even that drunk. I was just, pretty... I was feeling real good. And I shaved, and I woke up the next morning. I was like, never again.
He had this disposable razor in his hand. He's like, I'm going to go shave. Like, no, you're not. I just want to shave. No, you're not.
I got the same way. I came home and I'm sitting in my living room and I'm like, I'm going to shave. Like, it was such a great idea.
I literally sat on him. I sat on him like, you are not going anywhere.
Oh, that's fucking, because I felt the same way. I was so determined to shave. Like, it was like getting the beer munchies. Like, you're like, I'm going to sheets. That people do at like 3 a.m. and think it's a good idea to dry the sheets. But I
don't know if people across the country or world know what sheets is. Yeah, it's a gas station, but they have like food and shit.
Yeah, it's sort of like a Wawa. It's good food. Yeah, it is actually. It's not that bad.
They've got like made to order sandwiches and shit. I don't know how far reaching it is, so I don't know if people on like the West Coast.
And they get hip with it. They call it the MTOs.
Made to order.
Made to order.
I want them too.
Yeah. There's actually... what's her name? I think her name's like iJustine or something. She's some famous YouTuber. I think she's from California. Don't quote me on that. But she actually came to Pennsylvania to visit, and she made a video or a vlog or whatever the fuck you call it of her coming to Sheets. So I think other people have heard of it because she was like really excited. She's like, I finally get to go to a Sheets. And she was filming it and everything. And I think she's from California. So,
I was thinking about doing a vlog.
Really, you should.
I'm not even interesting, though. But neither is anybody else who does a vlog.
I know. They're just, they have tits.
You know what? I'll tell you what.
I'm being honest.
I'll tell you what. If you people would be interested in a vlog, leave us comments and I'll do it. If it's, telling me so that you want me to
do it. I actually thought of that because I want to do something for a Patreon. I actually want to show where I live because we talk a lot about where, how backwoods it is out here and stuff like that. And we are... Like, where I do the podcast, it is literally a town of, like, I'd say 20 houses just on a highway. That's it. And then
it's not even 20, I don't think.
Yeah, maybe 15, 12, I don't know, like that. But I don't know. I got to, like, edit everyone's addresses out if I'm walking
down
the
street.
Yeah.
I don't know. Speaking of Patreon, we got to get better about that. We have not fucking updated in Patreon.
I know.
Because we only have one patron.
Yeah, I know. So
thanks, Shane.
Yeah. Thanks, Shane. Love you.
But, you know, speaking of which, I guess that's a good segue. Hey, if you guys all start signing up to Patreon and pledge as little as a dollar, we're going to have some exclusive content for patrons. So if you don't want to miss out on some stuff, Casey and I have been kicking around some ideas for some cool things that we can do that'll be patron only.
Yeah.
So if you don't want to miss out on any of that, you can subscribe to us on Patreon. It's patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions. The links are in the description of the video or on the show notes if you're viewing on a podcast. You can always see some of the podcatchers do really fucked up show notes. They like take all the formatting I've done to it and completely obliterate it. So if you ever want to see good show notes, you can always go to our website at openlyhostileopinions.com. We have everything on there. We have the audio podcast as well as the videos. They're all on there. We have links to our merch if you want to buy stuff. We don't get a whole lot off of that, but it's more just, you know, it'd be cool to see you wearing our stuff. So
yeah.
If you buy a shirt and you will ever want to be featured on the show, take us a picture, you wearing our stuff, and send it in. We'll put it on the screen.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So, yeah, you're definitely going to want to start subscribing to Patreon if you haven't yet. You can literally pledge as little as a dollar an episode. Mm. So it's $4 a month.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure you spend more than that on a fucking coffee at Starbucks.
I know, because, like, me and Jay have been talking about doing something, and we want to do it for a while, but we just bills are getting in the way and shit. We want to do it so bad.
we need a little revenue to do some of the cool ideas we have in mind. We wanted to like bring a
give us money.
Well,
let's
just tell the people what we're planning. We're planning on getting a green screen in here eventually.
Yeah, that's what we want to do, but this shit's fucking expensive.
Yeah, we need to get a green screen in here eventually to start doing some more interesting backgrounds and things, more interactivity. We want to do more Wired Wednesdays. We've been haven't done one in a while, but we want to do that. But we can't buy products to review and things like that without money.
Yeah.
So, and trust me, we are not we're not begging anything off
I
the
am.
Show.
Give us money. No, Jay.
I'm just saying we're not making anything off the show, nor do we expect it. But
yeah.
If we could get enough to keep producing content, that'd be great.
And it's just like I want more interaction. Like, we're getting a lot more than we used to.
Yeah, and, no, that's great. I'm not shit talking to anybody who fucking just leaves a comment.
Yeah. But that's what we're just getting at. Like, we want our Patreon, you know, to take off and stuff like that. And we want more people to comment and everything like that. Like, me and Jay were just talking. Our Wired Wednesday, where we covered a headset, we have a guy here that I was talking to that, you know, we were talking just about wireless headsets and wireless things and how they've come a long way. They're better than they used to be. And he watched our product review on our headset, and he ended up buying one. And I was telling Jay, I was like, I think that's so cool that, you know, our review, we got someone interested in the product we were reviewing, and they ended up buying it. I thought that was amazing. And that's the kind of stuff we want. And it's just Jay's looking at porn. Yeah, what is wrong with your phone?
Oh, my wife's calling me again.
Why?
Because she doesn't know our show is going to be over in 7
There's
minutes.
There's a hair on your phone.
That's because I got cat hair all over me.
No. Yeah, why? Was your cat being extra lovey today?
No, I couldn't find the lint brush.
No.
I live with 3 little heathen cats and a dog, and I have hair everywhere.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah, so like we were saying, just, I don't know, just be more interactive, people. Touch my nipples. You think you're excited, you should feel these nipples. Oh, man, I love it.
We have 7... Oh, excuse me, we have 7 minutes remaining.
Yes, yes, we do.
Do you have another story you'd like to cover?
Yeah, actually, unless you do. I don't know, what do you want to do?
No, go ahead.
Okay.
I got one where a lady uses balls as a... testicles as a beauty brush, so
we'll do that. Oh. That sounds amazing. Go right ahead.
Okay, well, you can actually bring the video up if you like. There's really not a lot to say.
That's amazing. Oh, man. God bless her.
I bet you'll never guess which state she came from.
Has to be Florida.
You'd be correct.
Oh, man.
This woman in Florida is using her boyfriend's testicles as a beauty blender.
That is fucking amazing.
It's gone viral because, of course, it has.
Oh, God, I gotta show this. This is my favorite part. To be honest, it worked surprisingly well.
My favorite part is I found the story on Huffington Post.
Mm-hmm.
It goes, their quote is, video of Florida woman using her boyfriend's test. God damn it.
I'm going to start calling you Yanni.
It's not because I'm tired. It's just because I talked to
you. Do you remember Yanni?
I do. But anyway, he goes, video of a Florida woman using her boyfriend's testicles as a beauty blender has gone viral because, well, it's nuts.
I got to give it you. That's pretty good.
So not that anything on this show is safe for work, but yeah, this is certainly not safe for work. Go ahead and show that. Show the video.
Oh, wait. There's a video?
Keep scrolling. There you go.
Oh, what? There's a... This just
gets... You're about to see testicles on the screen. Just saying. Okay. Look at this.
Oh, we're so getting bad for this.
Yeah.
I can't wait.
It's nice because it's warm.
It's warm.
You think, bitch? Oh, that's great.
But here's the funniest part about it. It worked.
I know. That's what I'm saying. It says it worked. It, to be honest, it worked surprisingly well.
She got the idea, apparently, because evidently her boyfriend liked to put his nuts on her head for humor.
Oh, yeah. Every guy wants to do that.
I can think of better places to put my nuts than their forehead.
Yeah, I know.
Chin, perhaps.
I know, but it's still funny. I'd do her. I think she's cute.
I almost had my wife convinced to let me go raw dogging it the other day.
You passed the 40 loads.
But we haven't done the official testing yet. I almost had her convinced to let me raw dog it, but she was like, no, not until we get the test. Like, God damn it, I hate these condoms. I hate them.
I love it that you're married and you still call it raw dogging. Like, that's what I use when I fuck some hoe.
And you're No. Raw dogging as in bareback, no condom.
I know, but that's what I'm saying. That's the kind of thing I say when I'm talking to my friend.
Dude, like, I tell you, I'll tell you the honest to God truth. One of the tricks to staying happily married is when you fuck like you are on a one night stand.
But you don't
sit here and fuck your lady like she's the mother of your children and your best friend like she is. You fuck her like the dirty hoe that you envision in your dreams.
Yeah, that's like. You role play like, oh, sex life is getting boring. Well, let's go to the bar. I'll meet you there, and we'll come up with fake names and fake occupations.
Like, for example, you know, I'm going to get in trouble for talking about this shit, but...
She doesn't watch the show.
No, but other people who talk to her do.
Oh, great.
Anyway, my wife is a strong, independent woman, very much so. She's very... you don't fuck with Amanda. You know how she is.
She's Polish.
Yeah, well,
don't fuck with Polish people.
Regardless, you don't fuck with Amanda. She is who she is, and that's, you know, fuck you if you don't like her.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, when she's like that in real life, sometimes in the bedroom she likes to switch it up a little bit. You know what I'm saying? So you have to go at it like you're trying to punish her for wanting that dick.
Yeah,
she's not
gonna,
just her.
She's gonna fucking kill you.
It's not just her either. It's with all women. If you're married and you don't fucking still hit that shit like you two are still dating and you're trying to impress, if you don't act like you're trying to impress your woman with your dick, if you don't come walking out like, yeah, bitch, you want this dick, then you know what? When she starts straying for other dick, you'll know why.
I have a lot of friends that have been married and stuff like that, and it was the only marriage they ever had. And then once they, you know, get divorced or things turn sour, they have sex with a different person that actually cares about sex. They're like, their eyes are like, it looks like they haven't got sleep in their days. They're like, I didn't know sex was like that. I'm like, yeah, sex isn't supposed to be boring.
I'm not saying every time you got to bring your A game, because fuck, sometimes you just want to get it done and watch the Penguins game.
Exactly. That's true. But like,
sometimes you want to watch the Flyers lose another
match.
That's
what I say. Like, you know why I like sex? It puts me in a good mood. Like,
but you got to go at it like you're trying to get the job done. Yeah, you're trying to dig that grave.
Yeah, exactly.
You're trying to push that boulder up over the mountain. And if you don't, Then when she goes looking for other dicks besides yours, you can't be mad.
Yeah, exactly, man. You gotta beat that shit up. You gotta lay some pipe, man. Mario Brothers. Doot, 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 doot. Fucking hit those boxes.
That's it. That's our advice for the day. I think our show's over.
Yeah, just leave the donuts out. I'm sorry, dude. We gotta have a shirt like that.
I'm not making it. You wanna make it, you make it.
I'll take full responsibility for it.
I can't wait till Christmas, though. I got something special for you guys coming up. For Christmas, I can't wait.
I don't know. I have no idea.
No, I got a special one.
But I want to know why talking about donuts brought that up.
I don't know. No, I'm just talking about t-shirts. I got a special shirt coming up on.
I think a little
bit closer to Christmas time. All right, kids. We'll see y'all next week. Follow us on Google+. Follow us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter. All the links are in the video description and the show notes below. We're available on OpenlyHostileOpinions.com for all of your podcasting and video show note needs. We'll see y'all next week. Thanks for being subscribers. We love you all. And remember, make sure you hit it like it's your last time. See y'all later.
See you on. Have a good one.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. 2 Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.